It is time for the Writer's Block, our weekly look at all things sports. I'm Jenni Carlson here in the studios of the Oklahoman, joined by my good buddy down in snowy Austin, Texas. Holy cow, Cedric Golden. How's it going, buddy?
Man, got my galoshes on and a winter coat and some long johns and some short johns. Yeah, I'm feeling like a big old Eskimo in 45-degree Austin today.
Wow, I feel so bad for you. We got snow in Oklahoma City as well. It's feeling like a belated Christmas around here a little bit. But we've got all sports to talk about today. Super Bowl is in our rearview mirror, Cedric. They've even had the parade in Kansas City for their victors there. So we're kind of on the backside of that. But it was a great game. Another double-digit come from behind for the Chiefs. Man, that Patrick Mahomes can play some football.
Feels good to be right, doesn't it, Jen?
Absolutely.
I think we were on the right side of history this past weekend. He's box office, and don't be surprised if he gets $50 million a year. He is well worth every penny in this market. I don't know if any athlete's worth $50 million, but if you're paying that kind of cash, Patrick Mahomes needs to get a big old chunk of that change. He is 24 years old, and he's already matched Aaron Rodgers and Drew Brees in Super Bowl wins, and he's only going to get better. The Chiefs were down and out with 6 minutes to go, and thanks to two people, Patrick Mahomes is one, and Kyle Shanahan is the other. They pulled it out. Jen, what did I tell you last week? Two things. I said the Chiefs are going to give up some rushing yards, and number two, Kyle Shanahan can erase the choke tag because of what happened when he was a play caller in Atlanta. Guess what happened? Again.
Yeah.
He forgot to run the football.
Yeah.
6.4 yards a carry they averaged, but only 22 rushing attempts for the whole game. That's incredible.
Yeah.
And now that he's lost another Super Bowl as a play caller, in the last two Super Bowls that he's coached in, his offensive have been outscored 40-0 in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, unbelievable. It feels like the mantra that Andy Reid, or the boulder maybe that Andy Reid carried around as a great coach who couldn't win a Super Bowl, has now been shifted over to Kyle Shanahan after the way that the Chiefs came back. You know, to me, yes, Kyle Shanahan is definitely a part of this, but I think the Chiefs also get some credit. Kansas City gets some credit in this whole thing. Obviously, let's be honest. Early on, Patrick Mahomes was a little bit shaky. There were some plays that he did not look like a guy that was and is one of the greatest football players on the planet right now. Overthrowing, missing some throws, some stuff that you would think he could almost do in his sleep, and he's probably done with his eyes closed from time to time. But they got going in the fourth quarter, and Cedric, unbelievably, three games in the playoffs for the Chiefs in the postseason, double-digit deficits. They won by double digits in all three. And you've got a quarterback so young, a nucleus that's staying together, they're starting to talk dynasty. Is that a possibility? Could the Kansas City folks be pointing towards something even bigger and better than one Super Bowl win?
Why not? Why not? They have the best quarterback. They have the best core of receivers. They have a good offensive line and an emerging running back in Damian Williams. Why not? And add to that, Jen, the old guard in the AFC, and we're talking about quarterbacks here, that pasture is beckoning for some of these guys. Tom Brady, over 40, in the AFC. Phillip Rivers, late 30s. So those Big Ben, late 30s. These guys are not young. And then you look over to the NFC, Aaron Rodgers, mid-30s.
Yeah.
Drew Brees, 40. So the old guard is as prevalent as it was. There's a new breed of quarterbacks, and they can move and they can throw. Patrick Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, Deshaun Watson. These guys have changed the position. They're not guys, except for Lamar. You got to give him, he's a different guy. But these are guys that are looking to keep the play alive and then throw. And Patrick, to me, and I wrote this, I think he's the second coming of Aaron Rodgers. And if he's healthy, And the Chiefs continue to move forward with good drafts, surround him with some more talent on that defense, like bringing in Tyrann Mathieu was genius. Mm-hmm. And if Andy Reid sticks around for another 4 or 5 years, who's to say they won't have 2 or 3 more championships? I know I'm not betting against him, Jen.
Yeah, and you know, I think it's going to be interesting to see if what we saw with Kansas City, you know, so close to making the Super Bowl a year ago, had that late loss to New England before in the game before the Super Bowl. I think they learned a ton from that experience. I think they really now. Giving up those early leads, obviously, you might wonder, did they really learn? But they were able to win in all those instances in these playoffs. I wonder if you mentioned Lamar Jackson and the Ravens said, I wonder if what they experienced losing after such a marvelous regular season, are they now in position to learn the same lessons that Kansas City learned a year ago? We'll see, but I think that's a team that I'm really curious to watch. The Ravens have been so solid as a franchise over the years. Always, if they're not in the mix, you know that they're not far off. And so to now have Lamar Jackson in the position he's in, yes, I think Kansas City is well positioned with the pieces they have, the contracts they have out in front of them. Obviously, they've got a formula that wins. But I'm curious about those Ravens. What will this year, what will that playoff disappointment fuel next year? Will we look back and say Baltimore had the same type of learning experience that Kansas City had? We're going to have to wait 12 months to find out, but I think it's going to be fascinating to see how that all plays out.